especially around in the earlier 2000s, like that, they weren't all open-minded to just bring in any type of event there, right? But Wealthy Street Theater was always about that. And so, like, it took organizations like that. There was a hip-hop coalition in Grand Rapids, and they took a lot of reins too. And then my crew, you know, 616, and in the early 2000s, we kind of became the breaking scene.
So Grand Rapids, you said it's a small community, right? Tight-knit community, and often maybe overlooked for the Detroits and the Chicagos and so on and so forth. To me, that kind of spells out like a chip on your shoulder when you do show up to the jam. Like, yo, we from Grand Rapids, and we about to show you what it is, which usually leads to rivalries, right? So what were some of the rivalries between Grand Rapids and insert name? Like, what were your either out-of-town crew rivals or maybe other cities that you were rivaling because they tried to little brother you? Like, how did that work out when you guys were on the come up?
So we've had a few, man, because right around that time, it was popping again. It was breaking, was like bubbling big, right? So a lot of people were getting into it. So a lot of crews from our scene that are still around, all were starting around the same time. So we rivaled a lot of different crews because we were all right around the same like time and maturity within the dance. And so our first rival was probably a crew here from here, actually in Indiana, called Beat Sick Misfits.
Okay.
So there's my guy Roxit, and a couple other guys, Slim and Vision, a few other cats that were here in Indy. They were like a collegiate club turn crew, and we used to battle these cats at every jam because they were like the ones that would travel from Indy, and we were the ones that would travel from Michigan. And because we were right around the same skill level, we'd always get matched up in like top 16. You know, so we would always have this rivalry, top 16 or top 8. We'd always be battling each other, like the setup battle brackets, you know what right. I mean? Like the random draw, we just happened to get each other. Like, they're like, now we're going to put these two crews against each other. So that happened, man, for like years. And then soon that changed to our rivalry with Crook's crew.
He ain't a crook, son. He's just a short one.
Be hardcore with your hat to the back, talking about the gats in your raps, but I can't feel that hardcore appeal that you're screaming. Maybe I'm dreaming. This ain't Christopher Williams, still some MCs got the feel one, cats I got the feel some, to let niggas know that if you fuck with big and heavy, I get up in that ass like a wedgie. Says who? Says me, the lyrical. Niggas saying Biggie up the street, it's a miracle. Left the drugs alone, took the thugs along with me, just for niggas acting shifty. Sticks and stones, red bones.
So that one lasted for like 2 years. Cause like when they came onto the scene, they just went to every battle in the Midwest and won like every battle in the Midwest. And that happened for like, I want to say it was like a year or two. It was a crazy squad too, man. They were a good squad. It was like Adverse and Black Attack Lester Burnham, Joe Lethal, Mowgli Rock, Al Grande. Like they had like a really good squad. Birdo, they had like a good squad of cats from Chicago, and their whole purpose was just to go and wreck shit at battles, and that's what they did, you know. And so around that time, our crew 616 had been traveling a lot, and we had been building this like performance. So we had routines on routines and commandos and stuff. So that was like our major thing was like, we had this crew chemistry because we put so much work and effort into these performances, it just layered over into the battles. Right. And, wow. So we started to utilize a lot of those performances and those like styles for competitions. And, when we did that, we started competing against Crooks a lot because they had the same thing. Quick commandos, big blow-ups, but they were way more like tricks and stunts, but our crew was like all danceability, like full 64 count phrase routines, you know, like, so it was a good contrast. But we would compete against each other all the time, and we'd see each other individually, crew on crews, and our battles were like the most fun, man. Those were the most fun battles I think I had in coming up until that time. Those were definitely my favorite battles, man. Anytime we competed against Crooks was dope. For me it was actually going to the jams. Like, it wasn't even real, like, the jams are great, you know, and the cyphers are great, and I love competing against other people and just sharing with other people. But to me, it was like traveling with my best friends wherever we wanted in a packed little car with all of our stuff, and then having to bum around for a hotel room or a couch to stay on. Like,
for more quality content from Beyond the Cypher with Ill Skills, don't forget to press the like and subscribe buttons. Also, feel free to follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Beyond the Cypher. Let us know how we're doing in the comment section, and to make sure you don't miss anything from the channel, smash that notification bell. We appreciate the love and support. Peace. Until the next episode.